I think she just has a relatable personality that it's almost impossible not to like her when you see her on the air.
I think the best way I would describe myself today would just be thankful. The career that I dreamt of has somehow come true. So you talk about full circle. It's awesome to be able to do what I set out to do when I was a kid.
At the age of 12, she sat across from her family at the dinner table and announced to them she was going to be on ESPN someday. This is the daughter of an Army colonel who understood a strong work ethic and would come to find that the road to ESPN would have both awe-inspiring and spirit-challenging moments.
I grew up as an Army brat, and I didn't know any different moving city to city, country to country. By the time I was 11, I'd lived in three other countries besides the United States. In 1984, I moved to Colorado Springs, a year after John Elway was drafted by the Denver Broncos. I loved what that sport brought to an entire state. And that's when I really learned that to stay involved was to be around the athletes and talk to the athletes and interview, and most importantly, to tell the stories. And I knew that this is what I wanted to do. I just didn't know how I was going to do it.
In 1989, the Army called for Sage's father and her family to move again, this time to Indiana. Sage finished her senior year at Carmel High School, and after graduation, found herself at IUPUI.
And one weekend, I went to visit an old friend, another Army brat. She was at Notre Dame, and she invited me up to Notre Dame to go to a Notre Dame-Penn State football game. So I went up for the weekend, and I stayed with her in the dorm, and I went to this awesome football game, and I realized part of that campus life. And so I drove home from South Bend. I said, Mom, Dad, I have to transfer, I have to move. And the next day, the next weekend, the next week at IUPUI, I filled out that inter-campus transfer form. But it was inter-campus, IU or Purdue, which one do you want? Didn't want to be a pharmacist, but I knew sports broadcasting. They had sports communications broadcast major at IU, which was relatively new. So I transferred to IU without ever having been there. It all happens for a reason, and IU changed my life forever.
Indiana University indeed had an impact on her life, but challenges ahead would test her character and her will.
So eventually when I transferred down to Bloomington, it was a lot harder. And you have not many opportunities each semester to earn a good grade. I'll never forget being home at my parents' house in Kansas on winter break and getting a call from the dean. And long story short, he said, you have been busted. You have not one, not two, but three consecutive semesters with a GPA below a 2.0. I knew that, but I just was praying that no one else would find out, which was silly. And so he said, you are an embarrassment to the hyper school. You are an embarrassment to this university. Now, I do wonder, if he hadn't said that, maybe I wouldn't have had a fire lit under my butt to go get help.
I think she'll tell you that she didn't come here a total straight-A student where it was all easy sailing. She had some bumps in the road. She spoke, I think, powerfully about that at commencement.
I had to figure things out, and I realized that I needed help, but I'd been too embarrassed to ask about it. So I finally did, and several wonderful people in the hyper school came. It was a matter of me putting my embarrassment aside and asking for the help because the people were there. So I chose to fight for my dream. What is your dream? What are you willing to do to achieve it? And how will you choose to live the rest of your life? That was a turning point for me.
I am thankful that experience took place, because no one can ever say you didn't work for it.
After graduation, she took many opportunities in the pursuit of her dream job at the nation's leader in sports. From small stories in South Bend, Indiana, to finally cutting her teeth at sports reporting in Indianapolis, even moving out to Tampa, Florida. Sage stayed focused all the while raising a family with her husband, John. Then she received the call.
In 2004, I got the offer of a lifetime from ESPN. And that job that I said I wanted since I was 12 years old at 32 was right there for the taking. But I knew with being very pregnant with number two, if you go there right now, my family wouldn't be able to come first. So took a chance. 3 years later, they called back.
I think that speaks to her work ethic, her dedication, her native intelligence and talent, her knowledge of sports and her overall attitude. She's a mega talent with a mega talent job.
You can't get that out of a textbook to really look on television every weeknight and see someone who sat in the same position as you sat in.
She is inspirational professional and has become a role model for our graduate students, for our students, and really for Indiana University.
Without a doubt, her beaming talent and genuine personality helped propel her at ESPN. She has become one of the most versatile on-air talents today, speaking to celebrities, sports icons, and living legends. Yet she still has moments where even she has to pause to reflect upon her journey.
Very recently, the NBA Finals in 2015, I stopped about 30 seconds before that red light went on, and I looked around and the queue was just packed. And I sat back and soaked it all up and said, these fans that are going crazy to see LeBron and company try to get past Steph and company, like, they are who I was. That's why I wanted to do this. What a blessing that I get to host this. I get to be a major part of it. One different decision along the way, I'm not sitting here. I don't meet my husband at the library if it's not for Bloomington, Indiana. When I talk about IU, I'm doing so and coming to campus and giving back because that campus and those people gave to me. So to receive the Distinguished Alumni Service Award was just biggest, best, most amazing honor I've ever received. I've never really had a true place to call home because of all my moving and travels. And Indiana University is the one place that I know will always have me back, will always take me back and be proud to call me theirs. And it's home.